Yeah, and his whole face was up, so like the whole body started to move, you know?
You are fine.
Are you looking for food from John?
Well, chicken skin.
Want to do nothing?
Honey, you're a big boy.
You just don't feel good, do you? That's why I wanted to look at you.
I know, baby boy. You've got some stuff on your mind.
I don't care what they say, your skin should not be pink. I'm gonna call it over. Not like that. I don't understand why you wouldn't just give him the cytokine shot to see.
Yeah, especially if like the Avapro isn't really doing anything. Like, yes, it's expensive, good. But like, if it works, it works.
Right. And when you've got a dog, see, in my opinion,
having a dog on Avapro for a long time is expensive, and if it's not working, it's not worth it.
Mm-hmm. Well, and that's exactly how I feel, is that he's shown that.
Good afternoon,
buddy. Well, hello there. How are you?
Good.
They put it on the to-do list. It says only on Apple. Check irritated and raw skin. Try Cytopoint.
Oh.
Question mark, so.
That's good.
Was that part lucky?
Yeah. So now he's on the list, which when I can get them to do this part, that's a big chunk of battle.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very excited. How's it going?
It's going good.
Yeah.
I wanted to come by and see how you're doing. Guess you still haven't found that lost dog yet.
No. There's been, as of today, it's been 2 weeks. There's been 2 weeks of no sightings. So she's been gone 3.5 weeks now. So it's not worth it at this point.
I was hoping you'd have some little ones here, but I guess
not. We have one little one. She's actually out on a walk right now.
Okay.
She's a medical dog. She's got a mask that Pac is going to remove.
Oh, okay.
She's a nice little dog. And she's looking for either a foster or an adopted home to wait for her surgery.
I see.
You know, and to have a nice, quiet place to relax in. So, yeah, she's going out to potty, so she should be back in there.
I just thought I'd
go
by and say hi.
Yeah, you can do. Good to see you. I'm not a bird person. I had a boyfriend in high school whose bird attacked me on multiple occasions, so I'm not a fan. Scared the hell out of me.
Well, yeah.
You have a big bird with a wingspan that gets in your hair. It's a little scary. And his father thought it was funny. So whenever I would go over to their house, he would take the bird out.
A little bit.
That's true. I thought I would be funny too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the thing of it is with birds, they might do that, but they don't. Birds are one of those kind of animals. Okay, it likes you. That's
uh-huh.
why it's doing it. It's interesting.
Yeah?
That's how it's doing.
That's great. They like me a little less. Mm-hmm. That's one of the town members. Try to tell me. Just the other day, he went up to you. I'm like, nope. Because he'd get in my hair and he'd start pecking.
Oh.
And it hurt. Even with his curved beak, it still hurt. He was more like knocking into my head, but I could feel the heat and it was not working.
I'm sure.
I'm poochy.
You cured me. I've never, ever wanted one. I love animals, but.
I don't need a bird.
Nope.
I'm here. I'm here.
Find a good spot, right?
Oh.
I think the vibe is so intense, but I think it's a combination of pain and itching. You know? And I feel terrible for it because he's been with this a long time now.
Yeah.
Mm. I mean, even though he's missing back to the head, he's going to chew off.
How's it going?
It is. Sundays are quiet because it's not. And Sundays up at the grill store, I'm not really busy either. Get that rush at 2:40
Yeah.
Right before we close, but so we'll be moving probably January for our final location, which is at Grand Swan. So
that's gonna be a lot closer to where I live.
Yeah, a hell of a lot closer to where I live. I'll be less than 10 minutes away.
Sapphire, is that her name?
There's a, I think there's an S hook on her. You just have to slide that out.
See it? No.
There you go.
I don't know if she's smart enough to know that, huh?
Yeah, well, sometimes they hit it just right and it'll make the gate pop open. So. Well, the thing is I can't really go to them here.
Almost.
I want to take the beams and then the post of support because they're not. Yeah. So we'll have the whole thing, and it'll probably be like across the front where the two stationary panels are, will probably be solid. It'll be just like more like the same material as the rest of the sides. And then we'll just have a gate. So that should also make it, you know, we have to react because we don't have a lot of dogs here. So that's another concern. So if we have a dog that's really reactive like a flapper, we could just put a blanket or something over the gate. I was thinking 8 to 10 kennels down both sides, but if you're outside and you're looking in on the right side, there's like an office that's on, you know, that's like closed off, but it's on this side of the back wall, not on the other side. So you actually lose a little bit of square footage on this wall. So I'm thinking somewhere we'll have to get it, Brian and I. But I'm thinking we could probably do somewhere between 6 to 8 on this side and 8 to 10 on this side. So.
Area for
too. Which is why I really want them to be like this so that they're flatter and not like turn these lengthwise because we could fit more of them.
Yeah.
But then on both sides they come out further.
Yeah.
And I really want to have a big indoor yard. But he also has already, the owner's already given permission to do an outdoor yard as well.
Yeah.
Not if I'm more excited about than anything.
Yeah.
Because in the summertime,
when it's too hot,
like we can rig like a mister system in there so that when it's too hot to take them for walks, they can go outside and potty and stuff.
Yeah.
we did it. We did all the, Taylor Rain was right, Brian, with the emails. I just looked up him.
Uh-huh.
And they have on the list, it says mass on left front limb, verify neuter.
Sweet.
And the things I requested from him. So let's see who else, Ted.
Ted Tong.
Ted Tong. That's all it said, Ted Tong.
Ted Tong.
They said they were going to do it last week, and it didn't happen. She got bumped. I know they had a lot of emergency surgeries last week.
Yeah.
Doctors are coming in left and right, being hit by cars. Like, it's crazy. And I guess it kind of makes sense because there's so many sprays out there right now. Mm-hmm. So, all right, well, we'll get to it. I'm going to let you know. Okay, you have wet food on the account. But it's she says, I'm out of here.
Hi, Kayla. Good girl.
She just kind of gets the swing going.
I know. I know.
I know, Mama. You're going to get your surgery pretty soon.
Come on.
I know.
Hi.
You were here yesterday, right?
Right. Yeah.
All right. Now, this is awesome. This, you can absolutely use this. Hold it down. Do you want to keep the pattern?
No.
Okay. Yeah, no, thank you. That's wonderful. Yep, we, like I said, when we move to our new location, we're going to have about 3 times as many kennels. So it's going to dramatically increase our need for transporting the dogs. And that means I'm going to have more vehicles, which means I need a lot more crates. So this is wonderful. Yeah, absolutely. If you know of anybody else that has crates, it doesn't have to be this big, but if you know of anybody that does have them and is looking to donate, we'd love to take them because we're going to need them. So, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Yeah. Have a great day. Thank you. They don't believe that it hasn't metastasized or anything because they've already done the test works. So, Sapphire, you're fine. You're fine. I have to get pictures of her standing like that. I can see it.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at you, Mama. What are you doing? Are you having the best time with John?
Yeah, I wanted to see if I could get her on the bed, but it's the hind leg. She just can't jump. She doesn't have the muscles to jump.
The strength in them yet, but
yeah.
But even just this is a pretty big deal for her.
Such a good job.
I'm
so proud.
Somebody that works at Pack sort of lost the dog. She keeps asking me how she's doing.
Wait, yes, you did. Yeah,
she's been wondering why she's so
cute.
Look at you, little one.
So the first time she first came in, she looked just like her. She was just skinny on her.
They really are. They're wonderful.
I could tell that she had been malnourished at one time.
Well, she had, because of the Valley fever is a wasting disease when once it settles in their bones and their muscles and their organs.
And so when she came in, she looked just, I really, her body constitution was the same. She had, it had affected her bones. So she had like these protrusions and stuff. Her back, her hip bones were so pronounced that you could use them like ankles to pick her up. Because there was just, she was literally bones and skin. More than inside, that was about it. And now she like runs around and she jumps and she climbs and she's a happy dog. I mean, she's so to see her now, she is now where she was about 6 weeks ago. So to see that she's on the way and she's changed so dramatically. Because the first time she got here, she wouldn't walk at all. We had to use a cart and a wagon to pull her in because she couldn't. We take her out in the wagon, lift her out to potty, and she would be like wobbly and shaky the whole time she was trying to potty, and then we bring her back in the cart. So today she trotted in here. She's jumping up to everybody, like on her legs. And so